Hi, I'm Jen Wilbur. I am the Hawaii State Director for Planned Parenthood Alliance Advocates. So I am the point person for the government relations and policy work here on the ground in Hawaii for Planned Parenthood, and I help advocate for the policies mainly, and then our supporter base throughout the state. Sure. So I first came to Hawaii right during college, actually. Participated in a internship program that was a partnership with the CDC and University of Hawaii through an organization called the Asian American Pacific Islander Youth Violence Prevention Center, which is a mouthful, but they had studied youth dating violence in Hawaii. And when my cohort came in, we presented those findings to DOE staff as well as different nonprofit organizations. So that really exposed me to a lot of the work that was done here in Hawaii, the what the communities looked like, and just meeting a lot of people. And then from that, I went back and I graduated, and a semester later ended up moving back. And some of the people that I had met in that internship introduced me to people working at the Capitol, and I ended up working session. And that's actually how I got my feet wet in politics here in Hawaii. Yeah, there was lots of stuff in between. So I ended up working at the Capitol, I think, for 12 years for two different representatives, and really got to know the system and how, how laws are made here and what that looks like, from the perspective of the legislature. And I kept hearing different people come in through meetings and talking about how it looks different on the outside, like laws are made, but how they're implemented, looks a little bit different and feels different. And I wanted to experience that from the other side. So I worked after the Capitol. I went to a couple of different nonprofits and really kind of learned what I liked advocating for and like what felt really good for me and sat well with me. And I ended up working for a couple, and the last one before Planned Parenthood was YWCA Oahu, which was an amazing experience. I came in to help them save Fernhurst, which is a women's work furlough program, and really advocating for women in general, but just all sorts of things that really touch all communities in the whole state. And that was a great experience. And then this job became available, and I went for it, not because I really wanted to leave YWCA, but there's just not a lot of opportunity to move up and stay in Hawaii. And I thought that would be a great opportunity, and that's why I did it. So right now we still have several bills still alive at the Capitol. One we call RHEA, the Reproductive Health Equity Act, and that is to we're trying to codify all the different reproductive rights in that are currently in the Affordable Care Act. Just in case the Affordable Care Act ever goes away at the federal level, we still have those protections here in Hawaii. A second bill is the Data Privacy Bill. And this is for non-HIPAA related data. So if you're downloading up your period tracker app, for example, you would have to opt in to having your data sold or shared, which currently you have no rights, or you don't know where that data is going. So that would just be a further protection, and that states are starting to do that. Our affiliate, Washington State, passed that last year. It also would stop some geofencing around healthcare facilities, so people can't track where you've been, how long you were at the facility, and then where you're going after. We have found that a data broker sold information just about that for, I think it was 600 Planned Parenthood facilities across the country for about $120. Tracking people where they came from, how long they were at the facility, and then where they went after. So just get some more control over where your data is going. The last one, we are introducing a RESO that's really being driven by our teen council members. And this resolution would be a study of how sex education, which is in statute, it's mandated to be done, but how it's being done. And then where DOE could use some more help. And then maybe if we figure out where they're the pukas are, then we can help fill them in. Do teachers need more training, and how are they getting the training? Are they getting professional credits for those trainings? Things like that. So yes, I know that abortion is the first thing that comes to mind when thinking of Planned Parenthood, but Planned Parenthood is so much more than abortion access, and that is an important feature of healthcare. But we do cancer screenings and STI prevention work, STI treatment work, gender affirming care for those 18 and over. And hopefully very soon in Hawaii, we'll be offering vasectomy services. Oh, but there's so much more, and people, the whole host of services can be found on our website as well. And then that having the option, whether or not you take advantage of healthcare, really is a point of privilege. And I think it's a point of privilege. I think that's my job. Like I'm advocating for people to have that point of privilege.
Yeah.
At least experience it in their life. So to speak to challenges, I think that, one of the biggest challenges we have is just access to healthcare in our state. I think that many believe that because we have abortion that's legal here, that we just don't need anything as far as access. And I would argue access, not just to abortion care, but just healthcare in general, really needs to be broadened here. And I think that's one of the biggest parts of my job, is to really advocate for policies that affirm, strengthen, and broaden healthcare access, with an emphasis on sexual and reproductive health for me specifically. But I think for everyone, we need to start advocating and really speaking up about broadening healthcare in our state. Women and pregnant people from neighbor islands are flying over to Oahu for care during their pregnancies. And that's something that shouldn't be happening, but is, because of the lack of medical professionals on neighbor islands. So we'd love to see that get changed in the future. And just changing the perception that we don't need resources because abortion is legal here. I think that we have seen many bills introduced that fortunately were not heard during session, but inform us that there are those that would put our rights and bodily autonomy in jeopardy if given the chance. So I think that we as a community just need to continue to fight for broadening all sorts of access in our state. And again, my job really is to advocate for those, for everyone, you know, regardless of ethnicity, religion, and viewpoint. My job is to advocate for policies that affirm, strengthen, and broaden our healthcare. And I'm happy to do it. But we're going to need help in our fight to continue to broaden access throughout the state. We do have a location on Maui, in Kahului, and I'm doing my best. I got a small grant from PPFA, which is the national organization, to do some more outreach, but I've really been relying on small nonprofits and helping them to let them know, one, what we're doing here on Oahu, since everything's so Oahu-centric, really reaching out and trying to let them know through emails and things, what we're doing here and how they can amplify that by adding Neighbor Island Voice, because Neighbor Island Voice is so important in all that we do. And also just trying to get out to more events on Neighbor Islands to meet people where they live, because we shouldn't be expecting people to fly over to Oahu for all of our events. So really trying to get out as much as I can using that small grant. And it's not perfect. We could do better. I could do better, but really trying to start those conversations and getting people involved.